Hello, my name is Debbie Reynolds. They call me the Data Diva. Today I want to talk about data privacy and browser extension fingerprinting. So browser extension fingerprinting is the ability for a company to be able to identify you without knowing sort of your name, not knowing your email address. And this is a concern, especially around a situation where we're trying to move away from things like the third-party cookie or being able to identify someone if they don't want to be identified. So the way that this works is that in Google Chrome, for example, Google Chrome has over 1,000 popular extensions. So these extensions, let's say like one, an example would be maybe you have an extension that lets you print web pages to PDF. That's like an example of an extension. So when you install these particular extensions, when you go to websites, the websites may be able to identify who you are based on the combination of things that they know about your computer, including your Chrome extension. So for example, let's say you go to a website, it may know based on, for example, being able to figure out how to serve you up a website or how to show it to you, like if you're on a mobile device or something, it may be able to say, okay, you have, you know, you use a particular font, you have this type of hardware, you have certain these types of software things installed, and based on the combination of these Chrome extensions, they may be able to identify you individually. So basically, this is using something called a web accessible resource. So there are certain things on your computer that may be accessible that aren't private, that are accessible to the web. Mostly this is really for the helping you function or help extensions or other websites know how to serve you up information. But people can kind of reverse engineer this to be able to tell if you are who they think you are, and they can do this with these extensions. So there is a website created called Extension Fingerprints, and it can, if you go to this website, it can tell you sort of the unique things about your particular computer that could be fingerprintable. So things like your time zone, things about the type of hardware that you are using, like I said, fonts and these extensions. So I think the estimate is that if you have at least three extensions, they can tell who you are. So I think that when people are thinking about third-party data tracing or tracking about individuals and they're thinking about cookies, this is a great example of why just getting rid of a browser cookie isn't sufficient. So finding ways, you know, companies are really creative in terms of finding ways to identify individuals. So it's not just about cookies, it's not just about third parties, but there may be things just about your setup in your computer that may make you as an individual more personally identifiable. So, you know, this is kind of an emerging issue. I don't know what you would do to sort of change this, because a lot of these web accessible resources are necessary for websites and certain things to be able to communicate with your computer. But it is true that it can, you know, that combination, for example, that unique combination of things that you use on your computer may be telling more about you than maybe you want to be told. So we'll see what will happen in the future about how, you know, I'm not sure how you'd exactly solve this problem because this is kind of the way that the internet works currently. That's it. Thank you.